In ancient religious texts and mythology, from civilizations all around the world, there are accounts of catastrophic disasters and apocalyptic events, which are often considered to be stories of fiction. However, does the physical evidence shine a light of truth on the disasters of the past? Is it possible, given the amount of geological and architectural anomalies being discovered on the landscape of Earth, that there may be credibility to catastrophic events found throughout these ancient religious texts? In the biblical book of Revelation, it describes a hailstorm of fire and blood, raining down upon the earth, causing devastation and the death of all vegetation. According to Norse mythology, in the final battle of Ragnarök, a fire giant wielding a flaming sword sets fire to the entire world, leading to the death of all living things. In Aztec mythology, in the period of the Third Sun, the people were destroyed by a rain of fire when they violated the sacred laws of the gods. In Hinduism, the Agni Astra is described as a celestial weapon or missile associated with the element of fire. It is said to possess immense destructive power and can create a blazing fire that engulfs and annihilates its target. It is also worth noting that the reference to a catastrophic flood can be found in nearly every religion. So are these just ancient stories created for pure entertainment and that happen to be a bone-chilling coincidence? Or were they eyewitness accounts that were personified in order to understand the overwhelming power of the laws of nature? In many of these same texts, they also describe ancient and highly advanced civilizations destroyed in one form or another from either flooding, raining fire, earthquakes, or from some other form of natural disaster. But is there any physical evidence of the catastrophic events described in these accounts that could prove that they actually occurred? More and more evidence comes to light every year that challenges our understanding of the ancient past. There are nearly 200 impact craters that have been discovered to date, some of which are as young as 200 years old. These do not take into account any number of asteroids that may have impacted in the deepest parts of the oceans that would have been capable of causing massive earthquakes and tsunamis. Further physical evidence is the Younger Dryas black mat layer, which is a distinctive dark sediment layer found in various parts of North America, thought to be the remnants of a cluster of asteroids striking the northern hemisphere. It is also associated with the Younger Dryas period, which was a relatively brief cold snap that occurred around 12,800 years ago. The black mat layer is characterized by a high concentration of organic material, including charcoal, soot, and other various elements, such as iridium, platinum, and nanodiamonds. There are also the discoveries of advanced civilizations with architectural anomalies that are far older than we thought possible prior to the proposed advancement of agriculture. Sites such as Göbekli Tepe, Turkey, which predates other known monumental architecture by several millennia, was constructed thousands of years before the emergence of settled agricultural societies, and the site suggests that complex architectural projects and communal efforts were underway much earlier than previously thought. Then there are sites such as Tel Karamel in the West Bank of Palestine, which archaeological excavations have revealed evidence of human habitation dating back to the pre-pottery Neolithic period, around 10,000 to 8,000 BC. This makes it one of the oldest known settlements and is known for having the oldest known towers in the world. So why is there so little credence given to seemingly eyewitness accounts of potential catastrophic events and advanced ancient civilizations? Archaeologists, as scientists, approach their work using rigorous methods and evidence-based approaches. While the field of archaeology does indeed investigate ancient civilizations and events found in religious texts, if there is no available evidence, or the evidence is inconclusive, archaeologists typically prioritize the physical evidence over what has been written. So as to the credibility of these ancient works, only with the discovery of new evidence over time, will these stories become validated, and until then we can only rely on personal speculation and consider these events as warnings from our ancient past.